It started with 2,600 in March. That was special, therapeutic. Tonight, we're expecting the first T-Mobile crowd to breach the 10,000 barriers. We're bringing you up to Section 117. Hi, everybody. I'm Darren Millard. Win the game, take the series. It's that simple. But an added bonus tonight is win the game. The Vegas Golden Knights will clinch a series on home ice for the first time ever and win it in five. To call the game, Dave Gosher and Shane Knighty, Game 5, Minnesota and Vegas, guys.
All right, Darren, thanks very much. Yeah, the Golden Knights, Shane, they put themselves in a great spot. Two huge wins on the road in Minnesota. They've done so many special things in 4 years. They've yet to win a playoff series on home ice. They have a chance to do it tonight.
Yeah, it's still remarkable. They still have one thing to do, but they're going to be able to do it in the largest in front of the largest fans they've seen in over a year. And the opportunity they need to grab hold. That fourth win is always the hardest to get. But you look at it. They went to Minnesota building. That they haven't had a lot of success. Able to get two big wins there. They need to carry the momentum. And a big start tonight is important.
Yeah, the Golden Knights back here on home ice. Depth scoring has been a big key for this team in the playoffs thus far. You take a look at it, of course. This is the last game, the last couple of games alone. Mark Stone, two huge goals for the Golden Knights. Nick Waugh, his first ever two-goal game in the NHL. That came in Game 4, and it's been a big key to their success in the series.
Well, it's been their success all season long. If you ask head coach Pete DeBoer, he referenced it a lot. Depth, so important for the success of this team, and they've been able to get it in playoffs. It takes pressure off the top guys. You get everybody contributing that goal by Marchessault. Really started the first goal of the playoffs for them. After that, everybody came through. Patrick Brown had the massive goal on that come-from-behind win. Carlson added to it. Stone's heating up at the right time. Nick Waugh picking up a pair of goals last game. A couple of beauties for him. So important to have everybody on board offensively.
And we've come to expect it now from the Golden Knights captain, Mark Stone. When there's a pivotal moment in a game, he is a part of it. And he was at it again in games 3 and 4.
A big moment player is what Mark Stone is. It's the reason he was given the C. And as soon as he put it on, you could see it. Early in the year, he took over games early. And he's been able to do it in playoffs. A bit of a slow start through the first two games. Just one shot in each of those first two games. But got it going. A goal in game 3 that really kicked him into gear. Had a huge shorthanded goal. Last game went in, and the emotion, the passion he brings, that just filters right through the team.
And when you look at the back end, Marc-Andre Fleury continuing his stellar season. He's allowed just 4 goals in 4 games.
Really remarkable. Marc-Andre Fleury's been phenomenal, coming off a 35 save shutout last game. And you look at what he's been able to accomplish. We almost say, you've got to talk about him. Yeah, you do. He has been tremendous throughout this playoffs. And early in this series, he was the guy that held his team in it. That's what you need from a goaltender, somebody that can keep you in it until you find your game. And the Golden Knights have been able to find their game. They've gotten better defensively. They've given Fleury the goal support, and he's just carried on 13 games now, going back to the regular season, 2 goals or less.
Yeah, we mentioned the Golden Knights have only allowed 4 goals in the series. They've kept some of the top scorers for the Minnesota Wild at bay so far. Kirill Kaprizov, the top-scoring rookie in the NHL this year, yet to score a goal. How many chances has Kevin Fiala had to score? He's come away empty so far, but the list goes on for this Minnesota team trying to stay alive tonight.
Well, and for the Golden Knights, that's still going to be the same message, try and keep these guys quiet as much as they can. The one guy that really has been performing for the Minnesota Wild, Joel Eriksson Ek, coming off a career season with the Wild, had 18 goals in a regular season. He has 2 in the postseason. Actually has 4. He put 2 more behind, but they came back because of coach's challenge and offside and a goalie interference that went in favor of the Golden Knights. But Eriksson Ek plays on the line with Foligno and Greenway. Big bodies that crash the net. And Eriksson Ek's done a good job finding some pucks off the pile.
Has an opportunity to be a real special night here in the Fortress. The Golden Knights trying to close out the Wild and 5 games. They've closed out 2 series in their past in 5. Stormy has more when we come back.